Hello all, welcome to RotoTrainees.com. In this session, we'll discuss about the interactive report. Let's get into agenda. Let us understand about what is interactive report, what are the customization options we have, and the sample interactive report. So what is an interactive report? Basically, we know what is a report. It's nothing but a result of a database query. And in the interactive report, we have additional filter criteria, and not only additional filter criteria, we also have some set of additional functionalities where which we can use it for the purpose of formatting the report in our own way. Okay, we can customize the layout, we can add up the additional columns, we can highlight the columns, we can use a pivot functionality. Those all stuff are available in the interactive report. Okay, so some of the customization which we'll discuss in our demo is like aggregate functionality, compute functionality, highlight functionality, as well as group by functionality. So let us understand what are the steps involved in creating a interactive report. These steps are similar to the any of the report generally. Like first of all, we have to log into the Apex, create the application, you need to create a page, and next step is you need to select the table or the query and then run the page, right? So now quickly what we do is, well, let's just log into our Oracle Apex and perform the creation of the report. So this is how an interactive report looks like. Let us try to compare this interactive report with the classic report here. If you observe, in the classic report, you don't have any action menu, you don't have any filter criteria. But coming to the interactive report, by default, Oracle provides the search functionality, okay? And also it provides some set of additional feature, customization feature, using which we can design the report in a very efficient way, or based on the user, you can simply customize the, you can customize the report and display data the way you want, okay? Now let's go back to our application. So I'll just log into my application now. So I'm already there. The first thing what we need to do, we need to create application. Or if at all, if you are already have an existing application, you can just go with that. So in my case, I'll just prefer to create a new application. So I'll just say, create new application. Okay, Apex Interactive Report application. Okay, now you can just go with the default, or you can include the additional features or pages, but go with the default, nothing to change at this point of time. Can just run this application now. At login, ask you the login credentials, enter them. Yeah, that's it. So application is ready, but the report is not ready yet, right? Because if you observe this navigation menu, we don't have anything, right? In the hamburger icon, if you just click on it, we don't have any report available. So click on App Builder. Now click on Create Page. Now in the component, select the report. And then here, select the first one, interactive report. Click on next. Now mention the report name or a page name. I'll say EMP interactive report. And can go with the default, nothing to change. Click on next. And here I prefer to have a new menu entry. I'll select the second option. Click on next. Now you need to select the source type. Either you can mention table or you can select SQL query. So I'll go with the table and I'll just mention the table which is available, and you can just tab out, and automatically if the table is available, it will display the columns. If it is not available, it will not display anything. You need to make sure that the table is a valid one. Now click on create. Okay, the report is ready almost. Now click on this page, run. Yes. So this is an interactive report, okay? So now we'll try to perform some customizations, okay? Now I can just click on actions. And here if you observe, if you click on download, it will simply just download the data, and also it is providing some set of additional functionalities like the format you want, okay? Or if you want to send us an email, many things it will provide. So I'll just go with the PDF first of all, I click on download and just see how it looks like. So this is a PDF report. It does not need to write any additional functionality for the format the way you want, okay? You can select CSV and you can click on download. That's it, a CSV format. Now, the first thing what would like to do is, let me go back to my slide. So the first thing is I'd like to go with aggregate functionality. In the actions menu, click on actions menu, click on data, click on aggregate. So aggregate is nothing but now here, if you observe, I have some numeric column like a salary or a commission, right? Where I want to perform summation of the total data, right? Nothing but like a new aggregation, sum and salary. So it provide sum of salary across all the employees, right? Now we could see a salary column, that's it. Okay, now, again, I'll click on action, data, aggregate. So that's earlier we have used some salary aggregation. Now let us say I'll go with the count of employee. Okay, can we see count is 14? That's it. Now here, if you observe, by default in the report which we generated, we did not add the count or the summation of salaries. So now here, if you observe, let us say what are the calculation which you are using. If you don't want others to see it, what we generally do is click on the report. Click on save report. Now you can mention summation aggregation EMP report. Okay, and click on apply. Now here, if you observe, we have a default report which is a primary report and the primary report which is this one. Okay, now I'll just close this one. Okay, this is a primary report. Okay, so now this is a primary report, right? So now in the primary report, I don't want these things, right? Okay, that's it. So in the summation report, yes, our changes are there. So sometimes like where you are performing some calculation, if you want to have those set of things saved, you can save them as a private report. So now, as of now, we just discussed about the aggregation functionality. Let us discuss some other things like on the data, I want to perform a compute. So now what I want to do is I want to have a new column called total salary, which is a summation of salary plus commission. So click on action, data, compute. Okay, so I'll just mention the column label as total salary. Okay, now I'll select salary. You need to click on the column, okay, plus commission. Okay, but make sure that they are null, right? So there are chances they are null. So I'll just prefer to use NVL comma zero. Similarly, L comma zero. Okay. That's it. Our new column is ready. And similarly, you can save it as a new report or you can save the functionality to the primary report itself. It will replace the existing primary report. So nothing but this latest column will be available for everyone who will access this report. If it is a private report, only this user can access the new additional functionalities which we have added. Okay. Now the other thing which I want to do is highlight. So I'll just click on action, click on format and highlight. Let us say wherever the salary is greater than 2000, I want to highlight. Click on highlight and you can mention here on salary and you can mention the highlight color. Let's say text, I want to change it to something like this color. Salary greater than 2000, wherever the salary is greater than 2000. Okay, and also I just want to highlight only cell, not the total row. Click on apply. Okay, and you see text, wherever the salary is greater than 2000, they were highlighted and you can modify it. Let us say if you want to add up some extra things, let us say if you want to change the background also, you can do it. Okay, maybe this color. Okay, so this is how highlight will work out. And the other thing is group by. Okay, now I'll just click on action. I'm not saving it. Okay, we understood what is the purpose of saving stuff, right? So I'll just click on group by now. So the group by, what exactly it will do is like, let us say I just want to understand how many employees are there in a given department. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll select department, function, count of EMP number. So this will display us how many employees are there in a given department. That's it. Okay, now if you don't want this particular set of reports, set of additional customization to be saved, simply click on remove. That's it. Okay, these will get removed. Now click on action. Now final functionality which I want to discuss is pivot. So in the pivot, what I want to do is I just want to understand how many employees are there for each department based on a job, nothing but like for the department 10, for a given department, for a given job, how many employees are there? So I'll click on pivot. So now the main pivot column is department and the column is job. And what I want to do, I just want to do a count of EMP number. That's it. So this will display, sorry, vice versa it happened, right? Vice versa. Let me edit it. Sorry, row column is, sorry, here this one. Row column is I want to have a department and the column is job I want to have it. So for a given department, in a given job, how many employees are there? Right? In a given department, in a given job, how many employees are there? So this is how we can get the pivot. Not only this, there are a lot number of customization functionalities which we have. We just discussed some of the mostly used set of things. Okay. So this is all about the interactive report in Oracle OpEx. Okay. Thank you.